Photograph is a film which, like every other great piece of art, teaches us to appreciate the small things in life. In terms of cinema, it might mean that not the story, plot or causations are important, but how the characters interact with each other, and in doing so, what do they say? So say ABC are the events in a narrative. The focus is not on A happens, then B, then C, but what happens in the middle of those events. The journey, not the destination. It teaches us true love is not achieved by this or this. What we have in the movie is four characters. Rafi, who takes photos of people around monuments. Noori or Miloni, a chartered accounting student who Rafi convinces to act as his fiancée for his grandmother, played by Farooq Jafar. All three of these represent different subclasses in the great Indian middle and lower middle class. Miloni is the city-based, rich, linked to the NRI-related, studying a conservative field. The Dadi is the village woman, almost unaware of the city life, who lives not for herself but her family, and who sadly we have erased from almost all our films. Then there is the city-village hybrid Rafi, the migrant, who like millions of other villagers come to the city to make a new life for themselves. The fourth character is Bombay itself, where all these people meet. Our world is such that city people are said to be the most developed, which is not true. This subconsciously made me position these people vertically. This fact, I think, needs to be discussed more about. Horizontally is a much better way of positioning. The establishing scene of Bombay and Miloni is done with such grace. Right when we see her face for the first time, she is with her family and clearly wanting liberation from these people and the society which she is in. Next is this shot, and her expression is a mixture of happiness, contemplation and relief. She achieves this feeling only when alone, but the change of focus brings her back to the material world, and in the next shot too, where she is surrounded by all the people. Shots like these also show how trapped she feels. So it is due to this mental confinement she accepts Rafi's request to pose as her fake fiancé. As a fellow accounting student, I can somewhat take acceptance with her decision. Some viewers were unhappy that the reason was not told to them, but that is what Ritesh is telling us, that stories, plot and causations do not matter. It is the same anyways in every film. Also consider these two instances. In both, the story is incompleted.
अरे भाई अब हमारी भी कहानी सुन लो। अरे पहले जमाने में तो जहाँ माँ बाप ने हाँ कर दिया वहाँ लड़के और लड़की की शादी हो जाती।
In the first, the character chooses not to tell it, and in the latter, Ritesh cuts abruptly. This idea is constantly present in the movie and reinforced in the end too.
Story to same hoti hai sab filmon ki same.
People might interpret it as pretentiousness or even laziness on the filmmaker's part, but to me this shows how confident Ritesh is in the telling of his story.
Chale.
And this confidence comes because his characters and film form are so well-defined, solid and three-dimensional and rooted in the Indian society. It is pure Indian authenticity which is shown through these scenes. When Noori asks him this,
और कुछ तुम्हारे बारे में मालूम होना चाहिए ना?
Most of us would expect him to answer something personal like a hobby or a passion, cricket, music, whatever. But what he says is this. The putting of family at the forefront is something at the center of Indian culture, and it would be very hard to find this in a Western film. Next, in the bus where Rafi follows and wants to talk to Noori, in this 3-minute scene, no words are spoken. It is the innocence, shyness and a sense of anxiety which exist in the Bombay public transport that keeps the two half strangers from confronting each other. Not something like this, but the silence which speaks more to us. These three shots when Rafi goes to meet her dadi at the railway station makes use of the Dutch angle. This reminds one of Slumdog Millionaire. But that is made by a white man while photographed by an Indian. The difference in both these similar looking shots is that there is no music in this. It follows realism and not formalism. While Slumdog is made to please and excite Western audiences by adding quick cuts and background music, Photograph does not wish to romanticize Indian life like that. It tells us that it is part of our daily life, thus making the scene more authentic and double inverted commas Indian. What does a photo mean anyway? It is a snapshot of a moment in time, a frozen memory which cannot change. Later, the moment turns into a memory which is of the past, nostalgic. The film is also a nostalgia for the past. Rafi, Noori, and most importantly, Campa Cola. Campa Cola was started in India in 1977 after George Fernandez banned Coca-Cola and other American MNCs from India. The drink grew very popular, but sadly, American capitalism in a bottle flowed back to India in 1991 after India adopted neoliberalism policies. So Campa, however small, represents the nostalgic part for Noori. The ending is on a very happy note. Rafi is happy because he is in material possession of the small thing that the girl he likes cherishes.
For your special friend, Sochin.
Thank you, sir.
While Noori detaches herself from what she is.
Boarding pe aap hi ho na?
An accounting topper and hopefully tries to be what she wants. A free woman in a village which does not impose the restriction which the city life does.
मैं भी आऊंगी कभी।
गाँव? क्या करेंगे आके?
ऐसे देखने।
हमारे साथ ही रहेगा। सब प्रबंध कर देंगे हम आपका। बहुत खुशी होगी दीदी।
Throughout the movie, I kept asking myself, why in so many movies and books do we like seeing social and religious classes being intimate and intermingling with each other? Is it a form of rebellion to the status quo? Or we inherently like hierarchy and order, but once in a while try to retreat away from it? Whatever the cause, it has happened throughout history. Most of them unknown to us. Maybe this idea of permanent economic and especially social equality is the India we secretly desire in our hearts to move towards. More liberal, more democratic, more fair. But the people who cause it in the first place are the ruling class by filling our minds with hatred towards the other group by the use of media and propaganda.